So, Omkar, last time we met, we had, there was this concern specifically about M01, and
Yes.
you were concerned that this SKU was moving, was selling a lot, and we were not getting enough supplies.
That's right. Yeah.
So, what we've done is that we've created a ledger sort of sheet. We've tried to forecast on a daily basis, or not forecast is perhaps not the right word, compute on a daily basis what is the closing stock in inventory in the Madras godown
Sure.
for all the SKUs. So I just thought we'll share that with you, and would be interesting to hear your comments on that.
Absolutely, yes.
So this is what we've done for every day. We've taken the open stock,
Okay.
sales,
Starting with the
incoming.
first. So first you had the opening stuff. All right.
Correct. And then you had given a sales and incoming from Hyderabad.
That's right.
Basis that we have computed closing stock
That's right.
and
Okay.
open minus sales plus incoming.
Yes.
And this closing stock for 1st of April, we have taken as the open stock for 2nd of April,
Absolutely fine. Yeah.
except in cases where there are back orders. So, in cases where if the closing stock was minus, was negative, then we
Yes.
have taken the open stock to be zero.
Perfectly fine. Yes.
Okay. And then just to make things legible, we've sort of highlighted all the cells which are zero or lower.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah,
So
absolutely fine.
this is the big
So
picture.
how is it looking for N01 then?
M01, let's look. Yeah. So you started with 50,
Yes.
went down to 45, going down to
Yeah.
37,
Yeah.
going down to 27. So stock seems to be declining, no?
That is a concern, in fact. So what it means is there will be stock out in Madras for this SKU. And
Let's see.
after that, what will happen is immediately the customers will not see a stock out, but
Yes. Actually,
orders will
that has
start falling
happened.
on Hyderabad.
So that has happened here. This
Yes.
is on day
So you got four,
on
right?
10th of April.
Okay, so 10th day, there is a stock out in Madras, so orders will go to Hyderabad now It
after that.
became minus one. Yeah, see.
Correct.
Yeah, okay.
And
So
it has
10th,
started actually
11th.
becoming worse. Huh?
Yes.
It got
Yes.
minus 10.
Yes.
And
That
it has
is
stayed that
expected. Once it goes down, it is expected because there are no supplies for this SKU in the market.
way.
This is one of the new launches, one of the best sellers. So yeah, I think by the end of the 15 day, you have some stock. 2 units are in the inventory.
Yeah, there are some
That's a
two units.
recovery. That's a recovery. Yes.
So what is
the management process that is used here? So do you have a limit Yes, so
on closing
normally what we
stock?
do is we track something called days of cover on hand. So every day we track the inventory and see how many days of future sale should be covered with whatever inventory we have, right? So typically we see for fast mover mobile FSM that number could be as low as 2 to 3 days, but a slow mover it should be around 15-20 days kind of number, and that changes from business unit to business unit. For lifestyle, that number could be as high as 50-60 days as well, right?
So this you do on a daily basis.
Yes. So this is what normally we do to ensure that there is no stock out. So anywhere we have a 7 days ordering cycle, let's say. Anywhere we see that we have less than 7 days of stock, we will raise an emergency order and we'll get that SKU in stock.
So we did do that, Omkar, as you had suggested,
Yes.
computed Madras average inventory. Okay. So we
That
have
will be
not done it on
interesting.
a daily basis. Maybe the students can try and do it on a daily basis.
Yes.
But what we did was we computed for 15 days for each SKU, we
Yes.
computed the average opening stock.
Okay.
and we computed the average sales.
Average opening stock for that period, 15-day period.
For the 15-day period, yes.
Absolutely right. Okay.
And we computed the average sales for the 15-day period.
Yes.
And then we computed, as you had suggested, average days of inventory.
Yes. So, yeah, this is what I expected. You can see for the fast mover FSN, fast mover SKU, you can see it is as low as 2 to 3 days.
Yes.
And this is exactly why we need forward FCs. We discussed about why we need forward FCs. One of the reasons was inventory holding in forward, right? So the reason we created Madras and Cochin is just because of this. We can operate these FCs at very low DOH. Hyderabad can never work on these kind of numbers. But since there is a daily connection between Hyderabad and Madras and Hyderabad and Cochin, I can still work with these kind of numbers with lower inventory in forward FCs. I can still be happy with the overall numbers. So this is an inventory control mechanism.
So a daily connection basically means that in one day goods will get shipped, right?
Yes. Every single day there will be goods shipped. And
it'll reach in the same day. Same day or next day it reaches.
Next day it will reach. Based on the transit time, it will take a day or so. But every single day there is a connection. There is an opportunity to finish.
Okay.
Right.
So M01, you can see 0.74 here.
That is the key thing.
Yeah. So this is exactly the point. And another good point you can make out of this is the way the averages hide the data.
And minus 10 is gone, right? We can't see
it's
that.
Gone.
Minus 2, yeah.
Yeah, so as long as I see this number at average, at 15 days average, I will not know that there were cases of stockout. I will never know what went wrong in between, right?
Correct.
That's a classic example.
But already you would probably get a clue, right? Because if it's 0.74, then there's clearly something is a problem.
Correct. But that is actually the reason we don't want that 0.74 to come on stage. That is the reason we track this every single day. Track this number, and that is the reason we correct it. Make sure that it doesn't fall below a certain threshold, which could be 2 to 3 days for forward, 7 to 8 for deep FCs.
You're right.
So in this particular case, M01 would have triggered a purchase. On which day?
Absolutely, yes. So,
but it did actually. I mean, there's some reason why it didn't get triggered, but.
Yeah, so M01, I know that there is a supply constraint.
But there's a supply constraint, you mentioned it.
Okay. Yes, so this is a new launch.
So for on that day, on column AK, Milind, we have 4. So already 4 should have triggered, right?
Because absolutely.
It is 9th of April. Yes.
9th of April, but even... Yeah,
In fact, if you can just go back and look at average sale for M01, that should be the indicator number.
Average so it's about 20. No, sorry. This is. 15.
Yeah, yeah, it is 20.
20.
Yeah. So
the minute it goes below 20, you should get trigger, right?
Yeah. 20 is one day. So at least I'll go for 2 days of cover because there will be replenishment of a day and transit of a day.
So 40 days you need. Okay.
Below 40. That 40. Means I should get a trigger on the very first day. I think only first day the inventory was 50. After that.
Yes, actually.
So it should have triggered there itself.
Yeah.
But in this particular case, you're saying that there was nothing, it was not available.
Correct.
Even if it was triggered, nothing could have been done.
Correct. That is where we are dependent on external supplies, right? And we can function as good as what they can. So that is what is happening here.
Okay. Any other negatives that are there, Milind, in this chart besides M01?
I don't think so. Let me see.
Closing stock, I don't expect too many, except this one.
No, it doesn't seem to be, GV.
Okay, yeah. So maybe as an exercise, people can look at the other FC and see whether similar problem exists in that FC.
Yeah.
In terms of, it may not have gone negative, but it could have gone below this average inventory level that you mentioned, right?
Yeah.
So maybe students can do that for Cochin.
Yes.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. And another piece that probably you want to ponder upon is the distribution of days of cover on hand, right? at this L01, 02, 03 series, these are my fast mover SKUs, right?
Correct.
Typically, they will lie between 2 to 3 days in a forward FC. When you go to 3, 4, 5, these are my medium movers, which we call torso. They will be around 5 to 8 days. And when you move to the tail, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, actually the number will start shooting about 10 days. Now the question is, why don't we control the inventory in forward FC? So the question always comes that why do you want 10, 9, 7, 8, those kind of SKUs in FCs, right? The answer is this is because of selection, right? People will not come to any platform if they get only one mobile. Maybe they will do if the brand is too big. Apple can do that, maybe, right? But not otherwise, not a generalized platform that we are talking about. People need selection, and there will be different kind of people who will need different kind of selection. And this last tail selection is essentially meant for those people who want variety. There will be people who want mobile worth, let's say 1.5 lakh, 2 lakh rupees also. And this is exactly to cater to that kind of requirement. So we need to keep the inventory for even the tail FSNs, the tail SKUs. But what we sell normally is the head SKUs. So it's a mix and match.
I see. And so this, every business line has this pattern, is it?
More or less, it will be there. If we want to relate to the 80-20 that we had, the first discussion we talked about 80-20.
Correct. Pareto.
So this relates to the Pareto, right? So the 20 is your top, and then those SKUs will be the ones who are having lower inventory.
Right. So if I just see that, actually, we are seeing that most of the Pareto seems to come really from mobiles itself. Okay.
That is a reality, unfortunately. Especially if you do the Pareto on the GMV, the value, it will be mobiles which leads. Because look at the average selling price again, right? A mobile is equivalent to maybe 10 lifestyle products or 100 FMCG products. So definitely mobiles will lead in terms of Pareto for revenue.
Correct. But otherwise, you see, it's M01, M07, M03, M04, M02, at the most M09.
Yeah.
Those are the ones that are really contributing.
That's right. Yeah.
And then if we go back and look at the sort of days of inventory for these, right? So we said M01 was one that we had.
That's an outlier. But otherwise, if you see, the inventory will be 1 to 2 days only.
Yeah. Then there was M07.
Yeah.
And M10, nine. No, I thought?
09.
Yeah.
Now M09 is typically a high price mobile. So
I see.
Average sale, it's just 0.4 units per day. We're not selling too many of them, but whenever we are selling one, it is giving a big buck.
And this is what you were saying, that you need to keep it in stock because you want to give that option for
absolutely
the high end consumer.
Yes. So in this case, in the M's, you explained head, you said torso. Is it torso? No? Torso's body. Okay.
Yeah. So we normally call head, tail, and torso.
Torso. Okay. So which are the head? Which is the head? Which is the torso? Which is
head tail? will be the ones which are giving you more units. So your M01 will be head, M02 will be head, M03 will be head.
Okay.
M04 is also head. Your M05, M06 are torsos.
Okay.
And your tail will be M10 and M7 kind of M8 kind of example.
Oh, okay.
And this will be more evident if you go to let's say lifestyle or FMCG. FMCG.
Okay. FMCG.
It will be clear demarcation. If you look at around to less than 5, then 5 to 10 days and 10 days and above, that will be kind of demarcation. You can clearly see there.
So these will be your head.
Yeah. 3 to 4 will be your head of
And maybe these, sorry.
Last 3 will be your tail, and whatever is in between will be your torso.
I see. Like this.
Yeah.
So you're saying that the head is basically the things which are moving fast. So you keep a lower number of days of inventory, but you keep track of it very closely.
That's right.
And then the torso is kept, or tail is kept mainly just for variety, just saying.
That's right.
And the torso is what you do with torso?
Torso is mixed back in between. So torso is, it's basically going either towards head or tail.
Okay, you move it to head or tail.
New set of SQs, normally it's a new trials and all those things. So mm-hmm. it run with average inventory, and then based on the performance, let's say over a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks, a long time performance, maybe we move them into right zone.
Mm-hmm. Okay, interesting.
Very interesting. So this is GV. We had done this earlier with Omkar. We had discussed this ABC analysis, right?
Yes.
This is really some form of ABC, isn't it?
Yeah, this is ABC only. Yes. Yeah. Head, tail, torso is another name of ABC. Nothing else.
I see. And so your strategies are different for A, B, and C.
That's right. So, okay, replenishment needs a lot of resources, right? I need to run replenishment. I need to monitor each and every SQ in portfolio, make sure the stock is there in all stocking points. For example, we are talking about 3 stocking points here, right?
Mm.
But the stocking points could be a huge number, right?
Mm.
So for each SKU, for each stocking point, if you want to keep a track, then you cannot do it for the whole portfolio for sure.
Mm. Right?
So if you want to be precise and you want to make sure that things which are not, which are definitely not going out of stock, you can do it only for the head presence. SKUs, right? So it's again, that's another use of your Pareto analysis, right?
Mm.
The top 20% giving you 80% benefit is what we're looking at, right? There is disproportionate, what you say, effort to benefit ratio. And hence we focus on normally the head efficiency.
Okay. And those, so the head SKUs, you will ensure that you do not have a stock out?
Absolutely. That is what the endeavor is always. However, as you can see, that is the reason this M01 is part of this discussion, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the endeavor is to make sure that these SKUs don't go out of stock.
Right.
However, there could be external factors which will force you to control or go out of stock in some cases. But we try to minimize that. Yeah. And there is a specific term also which is used for specifically in terms of lifestyle, right? Mm. Lifestyle, we call this head portfolio as NOS portfolio, never out of stock portfolio.
Never order stock. Okay.
Never out of stock.
So the best example is what you can see on the screen right now. All 3 of us are wearing white shirt, right?
Mm.
That's another example. Another example will be black shoes or blue jeans, right? These kind of SKUs will be always in demand. Yes, lifestyle is a selection game, right? There will be new varieties of clothing, new varieties of, let's say, apparel, especially in women's portfolio, will be coming up every time. However, there are some basic items which are never out of vogue, right? And that is what we call NOS portfolio. So we make sure that these SKUs are always available to customer, and they are always available close to customer, right? Given price, I may not be able to host all my slow mover, all my selection SKUs very close to customer. For this example, when we are talking about if my FC or if my business goes up in Madras and Coimbatore, Madras and Cochin, right? What will happen is I will not immediately hire a bigger FC there. But what I will do is typically I'll take out my tail selection out of that FC, and I'll still run the business. I'll still service 80% of the demand at a better speed, right? Rather than making an investment call immediately, I'll start focusing on the head selection, focusing on everything. So that is another way in which we use this Pareto analysis or AP classification.
No, so this has been very, very interesting, Omkar. You know, to my mind, the biggest learning I have out of this is, of course, out of this ledger exercise, is that it is important to not just look at a one-day picture, but to keep creating pictures on a daily basis.
Or Milind, even average is misleading.
And average, yes.
Can't even do average. You have to do everything on a daily basis. These are actually these, you know, if you look at these good, well-managed kirana shops, those guys, every end of every day, that guy will balance his books. Every day.
Absolutely. Right? Yes.
Yeah. So that's a good practice. That's what was being said, right? I mean, you have to balance your book. You have to know, at least for the products that are very important, you've got to know where you stand on that product at the end of every day.
Yes.